With this animation, let's learn how hydraulic brake works and the procedure for brake bleeding. First, let's identify the components. That's the brake pedal. Then we have the master cylinder, which is in green. That's the wheel cylinder, which is in blue. And there comes our brake shoes. We have two brake shoes on the top and bottom of the wheel cylinder. Then the bleed valve, that's a hose for brake bleeding over there, and that's a jar for brake oil bleeding. So first, what we'll be doing is we'll see the basics of the working of the hydraulic brake, and then we'll see how the brake bleeding procedure is being done. So first, let's apply the brake. So I'm applying the brake, so stepping on the brake pedal. The brake pedal moves and pressurizes the fluid in the master cylinder. So that's a master cylinder in green. The oil gets pressurized inside and it moves. So the pressured oil enters the wheel cylinder over here. So that's a wheel cylinder in blue. So the pressured oil enters into the wheel cylinder. This pressure energizes the brake pistons, which are in yellow. So you can see the brake pistons over there, and it's getting energized because of the pressure. And the brake piston moves and pressurizes the brake shoes. So the brake pistons are moving against the brake shoes and resulting in the brake shoes to move. That makes the brake shoes move. See, the brake shoes are moving over there, right? And the brake is getting applied. So the movement of the brake shoes result in the brake to get applied. How bleeding of hydraulic brake is done? Let's see it. First, let's see the apparatus required. The brake bleeding is done through a bleeding valve. So where is the bleeding valve? So that is the bleeding valve which you are looking at right now over there. And there is a bleeding nipple onto it. We have just made it bigger so that you can identify it. And a pipe is connected to the nipple and dipped in a jar with the brake fluid like this. So this is the apparatus required for the brake bleeding. Now, brake bleeding procedure. Initially, top up the master cylinder, which is in green, with brake fluid. So sufficient amount of brake fluid should be available inside the brake master cylinder. Brake is applied by keeping the bleed valve closed. So this is the bleed valve. It is in closed condition. Normally, it will be in closed condition. So keep it in the closed condition. And two people are required for the brake bleeding process. One inside the cabin, the driver's cabin, to apply the brake pedal. The other person down the vehicle to open up and close this bleed valve. So now let's see. The person inside the cabin is pressing the brake pedal. So you can see the brake pedal getting pressed, and the pressure inside the master cylinder increases, and the pressured oil moves into the wheel cylinder. You can see. So the pressure increases in the wheel cylinder there. So right now what we do is that now open up the bleed valve. So the person down the vehicle open up the bleed valve. So the bleed valve is getting opened there. You can see it's getting opened, and the air escapes out with little amount of brake oil. So the air is escaping out from there, right? You can see that it's happening, and the brake oil flows towards the jar like this. Now close the bleed valve and release the brake pedal. So first you have to close the brake valve. That's the first thing to be done. So I'm closing the brake valve. As the brake valve is closed, the person intimates the person inside the cabin to release the brake pedal. Then he releases the brake pedal, right? The brake pedal has been released. So in this process, it is very clear that brake is applied by keeping the bleed valve closed. At the same time, brake is released by keeping the bleed valve closed, as in the animation. So the importance is that the brake pedal should only be released by keeping the bleed valve closed, or else it will suck the air from the atmosphere to the wheel cylinder. So the procedure is very simple. First, press the brake pedal, slowly open up the bleed valve so that the air can escape, then close the bleed valve, and then release the brake pedal again. So that's simply the procedure. So this process of bleeding is continued till no more air bubbles are seen. And one thing you have to understand, why the brake bleeding has to be done. If you see your hydraulic brake is not efficient enough, you need to see that air is entered into the system or not. So the air need to be bleed out. So the hydraulic brake system consists of hydraulic oil, and this hydraulic brake oil is incompressible. According to Pascal's law, when a pressure is applied on a confined liquid, The pressure is distributed in every area right angle with equal amount. So as the brake unit is a closed unit with hydraulic oil, this Pascal's law is getting applied. But gradually air enters into the system and the air is compressible. So as the air is compressible, when we press the brake pedal, the air gets compressed, which is inside the system, and efficiency of the brake loses out. So to avoid this, brake bleeding has to be done occasionally by opening up the bleed valve and doing the procedure that we have given you through the animation. So I believe this was useful to you. Please click the subscribe button for more tutorial video updates. Please see the description below the video for more links. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.